Live in HD from the station that brings you more West Texas news. News West 9 at 6 starts now.
Well, new tonight at 6, a mother says that cell phone video is evidence of brutality by law enforcement in Kermit. And she says her son was the victim.
Devin Sanchez went to Winkler County today and showed this video to the sheriff to get an explanation. She joins us now with this News West 9 exclusive.
That's right. I sat down with Sheriff George Keely today and we watched the video. He says there is nothing out of the ordinary going on. He even tells us the day after Adam Viera was arrested, he went and checked on him and Viera didn't complain about anything. We also spoke to Viera's mom and she says even if her son committed a crime, he's still a human.
It's a classic he said, she said. Ofelia Enriquez says her son is a victim of police brutality at the hands of Winkler County Sheriff's deputies.
What could he have done to him to be getting hit? He was handcuffed, he was sitting in the car.
But Sheriff George Keely says, not so fast.
I don't think we did anything wrong. I don't think we mildly did anything wrong. I don't think we were even close to use an excessive force. If anything, we may have not used enough force.
Enriquez's son, Adam Viera, was arrested April 1st after deputies received a call about a reckless driver. We're told the deputy who worked the case tried several times to pull Viera over, but he wouldn't stop. So the deputy chased him until Viera finally stopped and ditched the truck.
Where the driver jumped out of the vehicle, ran up on the porch of the house, which was his brother's residence. Deputies right behind him saw him do it.
According to the report, Viera then became combative and refused to put his hands behind his head or identify himself.
They told him he was under arrest, at which time he started resisting. They put him on the ground, which is our policy.
Enriquez says this is when deputies went too far.
He was in handcuffs and he was already down, and Sheriff Mitchell tased him.
But Sheriff Keely says that's not exactly accurate.
They were trying to cuff him, but they couldn't. And he was rolling and kicking and fighting him. The one deputy said, stop resisting or I'm going to stun you.
And he did. Sheriff Keely tells us right in the shoulder. But the sheriff says he was not hit when he was put in the car. Right here is where Enriquez claims deputies hit her son as they were putting him in the car. We showed Sheriff Keely the video and he doesn't think his deputies were in the wrong.
Person fights with you. The law says we have to use the force. The reasonable force. I mean, that to me, that's what they were doing. Of course, they're going to be rough with him. He's fighting with him. It is a fight. I looked at the video. I didn't see anything out of line. I'm going to pass that on to the Texas Ranger.
We did obtain a list of charges against Viera. There are 7 in total, including evading, DWI, 2 counts of assault of a public servant, and falsifying a drug test. Still, according to Enriquez, her son was manhandled for no reason.
They think the badge makes him tough, and that's not right.
We're not above the law. We're keepers of the law. We are peacekeepers.
Viera is still in jail. Also in the police report, we learned Viera was taken to the hospital for a blood alcohol test because he refused one by the deputies. The report says while at the hospital, Viera fought officers and hospital staff for about 45 minutes. He spit at them and he told one of the officers he was going to, quote, rape his wife and said he would get the deputy back when he wasn't wearing his badge. Devin Sanchez, News West 9.